Where do you get your wisdom from? Boy, and that could go about anywhere, couldn't it? And we're not knocking wisdom. We think you should go to college if that's what you're called to. We think you should learn what you need to learn if that's what you're called to do. But we want to look at God's word to understand what he's talking about when he talks about the wisdom. Hey, welcome to another Capra Convo. Hope your new year is the best one you've ever had. We're here to talk to you about a few things, but we've got another question to ask you. Where do you get your wisdom from? Boy, and that could go about anywhere, couldn't it? And we're not knocking wisdom. We think you should go to college if that's what you're called to. We think you should learn what you need to learn if that's what you're called to do. But we want to look at God's word to understand what he's talking about when he talks about the wisdom. In this new year, I need all the wisdom that God has given, and I say given past tense, because we got some decisions to make about life, about what's going on. And Denise, if you'd start out, we're going to look at James chapter 1, and we're going to start out with verse 2. You want to read that just in the... King James.
Yeah, King James Version. My brethren, count it all joy when ye fall into diverse temptations, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience.
Good point.
But let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, that giveth to all men liberally, and upbraideth not, and it shall be given him. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For he that wavereth is like the waves of the sea, driven with the wind and tossed. For let not that man think he shall receive anything of the Lord, because a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways.
Don't want to be that guy. So let's just break that down a little bit. We have temptations, we have trials. We've been through the craziest time of our life over the last 2.5-3 years. So trials, temptations, tests came. Now, I can't say that God brought those tests, but tests came. But we're saying that he's there to help you out of them, to get you wisdom through those. But God is not sending these tests and trials to see what you're made of. Those are just part of life. But your response in faith will show God what you believe.
Well, further in James, it even explains that so clearly. Don't be deceived. God's not mocked. There's that passage that says, help me. It's clear that don't say God is tempting you with evil.
He's not doing it. God does not tempt with evil, nor is he evil. So if you get in these tests and they have some evil format, or you can say, man, this comes from evil, which we've seen a lot of, it's not from God. But one of the things we do want to look at, and we pointed this out, Denise, it says that the trying of your faith, and different versions put this differently, worketh patience. And we want our patience to be worked, but some versions put produces patience. And the thing we want to make very clear here, your Holy Spirit, the gifts, the fruit of the Spirit, one of the fruits is patience. So you already have the fruit of patience in you right now. So we don't need to produce patience. We need to work the patience that you've already got. Any comment on that, Denise?
Well, for sure, because it's an incorrect translation to say it's producing, because patience is in you. It says from the scriptures, Romans 15, we get patience from the scriptures, and it's really... faith over time, constancy, or the capacity for calm endurance. So when we are exercising a muscle, that's what we're doing. When we worketh patience, we're exercising what we have by keeping our faith and trust in God's promise and his word. And so it's incorrect, and it's so subtle, but it's very damaging and undermining to our faith in God when we say, when we start glorifying trials as though God sent them to make you better.
Come on.
Because that's not the truth. The enemy uses tests and trials to destroy us, to steal the seed of the word.
So if you've been through a trial, let patience have its perfect work. Draw on God and say, God, I'm not going to freak out. I'm not going to get in fear. I'm going to trust you by faith that you're going to reveal to me the answer I need to know as I walk through this. But it says, but let patience have its perfect work. And so I'm going to let it have its work so that I may be perfect, entire, wanting nothing. Come on. How many want to be perfect, entire, wanting nothing? That's where we should be. And if any of you lack wisdom, and this is where we're going with this too, we all lack wisdom in knowing certain things, certain answers that we need. How many have wondered, when is this plandemic going to be over? When is this crazy thing with the government going to be over? No, we're letting patience have its perfect work. We're saying, God, you got something planned here, and I'm going to be a part of it. But here's what we can do. It says, if you lack wisdom, ask God who gives to men liberally. Different versions use other, generously. God has, past tense, through the Spirit, has given you generous wisdom. But Denise, we need to draw on it. Yeah, what if you already know you've got the wisdom? Would that help you?
Well, here's what helps me is this cross-reference verse in 1 Corinthians 1, verse 30. But of him you are in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God, and righteousness, and sanctification, and redemption. That is, as it's written, he who glories, let him glory in the Lord. This really helps me, because this is saying, rather than me like thinking I've got to strive for more wisdom, no, this is telling me I'm in Christ, who became for us wisdom. So that wisdom is in me. Now, of course, the more I meditate and reflect, consider, ponder, chew upon the promises, the truth of God's word, I'm going to be extracting his practical wisdom. And so that's going to give me the power of endurance. I'm going to be filled with hope. I'm going to be refreshed. I'm going to be encouraged. And it's just a practical application of acknowledging what we've already got.
And so then it goes on here to say, but let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. Now, what I want you to get here is, do you trust God? Do you believe God is giving you generous wisdom at time of need? See, we need to get ourselves to that place that God is my daddy, just like you, possibly many of you were the daddies or are the daddies of children. And there's not anything you're going to hold back. And if they need wisdom, man, you're there to give it. So we've got to start expecting that.
And he's always speaking. He's our counselor. You know, think about this verse, that beautiful passage out of Isaiah that we just reflected on at Christmas that talks about he's the Prince of Peace, Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God. And it says the government shall rest on his shoulders.
Come on.
The government of God, not our government, not world governments, the government of God rests on his shoulders. Who is the shoulders? We are the body of Christ.
Oh, come on.
So God's wanting us to look at the Spirit of God within and start drawing upon that and acting out boldly and confidently who he's called us to be.
We've got to be kingdom people.
Yeah.
And understand that the kingdom rests with us here on earth, and we're bringing it forth. We're establishing it here on the earth. Now I want to look at one more part of this scripture, Janice, but it says, for he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea driven with the wind and toss. For let not a man think that he shall receive anything of the Lord. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Now, I do want to make a point here. I've heard somebody share this before, and it just really pierced me. A double-minded man could be a double-covenanted man. If you're still trying to operate under the old covenant in your ability, or trusting in God in the new covenant, you're going to be thrown back and forth by the waves. Well, I'll operate in faith, but I'll still do everything I can in my ability by the law and trusting that. You can't do that. You'll be a double covenanted man, and you will be unstable in all your ways. What would you say about that, Denise?
Well, that's again, just that little tweak, that trick of the enemy to get us into striving and performance. And I'm all for achieving goals and accomplishing things and acting on what we believe. But it's got to be from that position of resting in the fulfilled work of Jesus Christ.
Not striving in my ability, but resting in his ability.
Well, because we'll always look at ourselves and think we have not done enough. We need so much change in this world. We have just not done enough. When God doesn't want us in that MO, he wants us to be in peace. He leads us beside still waters. We love and glean from the wisdom and revelation in the Old Testament because that's a part of the Word of God that we learn from. But we've got to understand the part that's fulfilled of Christ's finished work. And now we're enforcing the defeated enemy, standing in faith. It just gives us way more confidence than us thinking of ourselves fighting the devil off.
Come on. I hope this blessed you today. I'm going to pray for you today and pray you get a revelation of this. Father, I thank you for the people listening and going to be listening to this. And I pray, God, that they would not be double-minded, double-covenanted people, but they be people of faith that have trusted what you've already done, the wisdom that you've already given us, and the generous wisdom that we're receiving right now in the name of Jesus.
Yes, and I just pray for a citizen's awakening in our nation to take hold of what God's called us to, the freedom that we have. Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty which Christ made you free. Standing fast means we are immovable about it because it belongs to us. So God, we thank you for that we're courageous people that are overcoming in this time because of your finished work and for us.
Bless y'all. We'll see you again soon.